So we have started our third unit, right? So yesterday we have discussed one topic, that is cloud architecture layer. Okay, we'll see one quick recap on this, right? So we are going to, we have seen that cloud architecture, right? So mainly this cloud architecture consists of like a four layers, right? So this architecture means for every model there will be a some architecture, right? So how it works, what is its functioning. So according to that, here we are going to be utilizing the architectures, right? So mainly this cloud functioning depends on the internet now. And it will consist of four layers, right? So before going to this architecture, first of all, we have to understand about the SLAs, right? Service level agreement, right? So what is this service level agreement, ma'am? Service level agreement. What is service level agreement? Between whom it will be happen? Chat me. Service level agreement. Okay, user and the service provider. Right, Jashwanti. So here service level agreement will be done between the user and the service providers, right? So here when we are utilizing the service level agreement means whenever you are taking any service from the service provider, right? At that time the service provider will be providing one agreement, right? So means he is providing some terms and conditions. According to that, we are going to be utilizing the services and we are doing some promises so that we cannot, we are not going to cross any limits or we are not going to be misusing. These all things will be there. Okay, so we are doing some promises in that and we are utilizing the services from the cloud, right? So mainly here we are doing some agreement whenever we are using any hardware or the cloud resources. At that time we are using, right? So definitely, for example, like whenever we visit to theaters or the parks, at that time also they will be providing some terms and conditions, right? So don't bring the food, okay? Like don't bring some plastic covers, like that. Whenever we visit to our malls or theaters or anywhere, at that time, definitely they will be providing some rules and conditions, right? Like terms and conditions. Based upon that terms and conditions, we are going to be following and we are going to be utilizing the services. Same like that only here, SLAs also. Here, service providers are providing some agreement with the users. Based on that, we are going to be utilizing the services, right? So in this SLAs, it is going to be include complaints also, ma. Okay, mainly complaints. So you are promising that you will be providing the services to me, okay, whenever I hosted my website, right? At that time, at a time all subscribers has been increased, so here service provider unable to provide the service, so my server was down. Okay, my server was down for 10 minutes, so I has huge loss in that, right? So in that case also you can claim your amount. Okay, you can we can do a penalty. Okay, we can file the case. These all things also happen in this SLAs, right? These all can done by the users also, right? If anything happens in that, right? So that is the SLA. Simply the SLA is nothing but whatever the services we are utilizing from the services, okay, we are making some agreement between the service provider and the users, okay, we are following some terms and condition. And the second things here, it is going to be including the complaints also. Whenever they are unable to provide services properly, at that time we can do the complaints and we can we can claim the amount, okay, or we can file the case on that also, right? So this is about the SLA. So remember about this SLA. Whenever we are using the word SLA means these all things will be happen, right? So here we are having the four layers, right? So here we are having four layers, right? So one is the, what is first layer, ma? What is first layer? User and client's layer, right? User or client's layer, right? And Second layer is network layer, right? And third layer is hardware layer, sorry, cloud management layer, right? And at last, fourth, hardware resource layer, right? So here, user and client, mainly here, user and client layer, why we people are using? What this layer will be doing? Need answers. First of all, it is the lowest layer in the cloud architecture, right? Right? So this layer totally belongs to whom? This layer is totally belongs to whom? Users, right? Users, right? So mainly in this layer, what we are initiating, ma? We are in this layer one, mainly what we are initiating, ma? Okay, cloud. What is cloud? Incomplete answer, ma Manisha. We are initiating connections to the, yes, right. Very good, Amisha Patel. Okay, Manisha Jeshwanti. Right, ma. So here we are initiating the connections to the cloud, right? So here clients are going to be accessing with any devices. Like what kind of a devices they are accessing? Mention the names of that. We have discussed that devices names also. Okay, thin client, okay, thick client, mobiles, handheld devices. Very good, ma. Very good. Okay, very good. So here means layer one, mainly here we are using for opening our application or to access the clouds, right? So for example, like whenever we are opening our Gmails, okay, at that time here we are going to be utilizing the browsers and the internet connections. With the help of that, we are going to be connecting to the cloud. Okay, here connections are going to be initiated to the users, right? And in this layer one, SLA is not applicable. Okay, SLA is not applicable. Everything will be done by on our own system. We are going to be initiating the connections. Okay, SLA will not affect in this layer one. Okay, here it is going to be providing the access to the cloud, right? That is a layer one. And layer two, network layer. What this network layer will be providing, ma? Here, what it will be doing? Network layer. I need answers, quick answers. Network layers. It allows the users to connect, ensures the cloud connection, right? Okay, very good, ma. Amisha Patel. Okay, very good. So it is going to be allowing users to connect to the cloud, right? And it is providing the cloud infrastructures, okay, depending on their connections, right? So there will be a difference for public cloud and the private clouds, right? So in this layer, SLA will affect or not? In this network layer, SLA will affect or not? Okay, no SLA, right, Shrestha, Manisha, yes, very good, excellent answers from you. Really, I am happy today. You are giving a good gift on this day. Okay, so in this network layer, so for example, whenever we are connecting to the Facebook or Instagram or any applications, ma, at that time, first of all, we are going to be entering into the layer one. Okay, we are accessing with our mobiles, right? After that, second thing, what we are doing? To connect to the Gmail or any application, definitely we need internet connections. Okay, from our mobile data. Okay, from our mobile data, we are going to be connecting to the cloud. Okay, and here network is going to be providing the services. From mobile data, we are going to be utilizing the services. So simply here it will be establishing a connections, okay, in the network layer, right? So SLA will not consider in this layer two, right? So why? Because means, for example, SLA, why it is not affecting means, for example, you people are accessing any data or any Amazon data, okay? Your data has been stored in your Amazon AWS, okay, in your mobile. From your mobile, you are going to be accessing from the layer one, ma. Okay, so layer two, what will be happening means, so whenever you have visited to some other places, right? So like railway stations, okay, you people are traveling. At that time, you are getting that free Wi-Fi is available. So that what you people will be doing? Array free Wi-Fi vastundi kada ani meer em chestaru? You people will be immediately connecting and doing some downloads or some files, everything you will be starting, right? So you have started download, and the so in this case what it will be happen means never use the free Wi-Fi, Sma. Why? Because your data, your everything will be stolen. Okay, that will be a not secure. Okay, so they can store they can access, they will get your data, and there will be a no security for your data, whatever you people are utilizing, right? So suddenly you have seen that you have lost some information and your information has been leaked, right? So you have complained to the service provider, here I have used some private cloud and everything, but my information or these all things has been lost. Okay, so you have done the complaints to the service providers. So what this service provider has been checked, he has checked what you have done, everything. Okay, you have access to the free Wi-Fi and you have given the permission there only, right? So in this case they are not responsible, right? In this case they are not responsible that you are utilize whenever you are utilizing the free free services, right? That's why layer 2 is not affecting with the SLAs, right? In this layer 2 they are not going to be considering whenever we are using these all the things, we are only giving the permissions for everything. At that time, here SLA is not going to be affecting in this network layer, right? Clear? That will be the network layer. So first layer and the second layer, there will be a no networks, no SLAs. Okay, they are not going to be applicable with the SLAs. Okay, directly we and the users are going to be utilizing the services. And the third layer, that is cloud management layer, right? What is this cloud management layer? What is this cloud management layer? Mainly it consists of, okay, mainly it consists of, yes, very good, Amisha Patel. Mainly it consists of softwares, right? So it is having like a OS, it will be providing OS, operating system. What OS will be doing? Acts as an interface between the users and the data centers, right? Resource management will be there. Okay, scheduling, provisioning, these all things will be done, right? This layer is very, very important, ma. Cloud management layer, it plays a major role in the cloud for providing all the resources, connecting to the user systems, internet, everything. So at that time, it have to handle and control these all things, right? So cloud management layer is very important. In this layer, they are going to be utilizing the virtualizations also. Whatever we have discussed in the previous classes, based on that only, here they are going to be providing the services, right? So in this cloud management layer, SLA will comes in the picture, okay? So here SLA will be affecting in this layer, right? According to that only we are going to be utilizing the services, right? So this layer comes under the SLAs. So based on that SLAs only here services are going to be providing, right? So here whenever, for example, whenever we are using our Gmails or anything, right, you people are getting some 15 GB space, right? That is not fixed for you, ma. Okay, it is not fixed for you, right? So whenever we are utilizing, according to that, service providers are going to be providing, right? So here, whatever we are storing our data, okay, we are storing our data into the clouds, okay, that space is not fixed for us. Okay, they are going to be sharing with the multiple clients, okay? Like that only they will be sharing hardware, softwares with multiple clients and the users, right? So in this layer, exactly we don't know where our data center is there, okay, where our data is storing, okay, exactly we don't know, right? And here in this, it is not giving any guarantee that separate 15 GB, whatever the Gmail GB is there, okay, free space is there, that is separately, and that is only we are utilizing separately. Okay, that is not only for one person. Okay, it will be shared it for the many or multiple clients, right? So here what that service providers will be doing means, here they are going to be taking one hard disk, might consist of like a 1 TB, right? So whenever you are accessing to the cloud, if you are storing any data or Gmail data or anything is there, okay, They are going to be storing in that hard disk 1 TB, right? Along with that, they are going to be sharing with the multiple clients also, okay? And whatever the software, wherever your data has been stored, okay, from Gmail or Facebook or Instagram, okay, from anywhere, along with that, they are going to be sharing with the others also. That 1 TB is not fixed for you, okay? Other users are going to be storing in that, and they are going to be providing the services to the multiple clients. Okay, that's why exactly we don't know where the data is going to be stored, and there will be a no guarantee. Okay, and we don't know that our data is safe or not. Okay, so like that, here cloud management, it will be going to be managing all the spaces according to the user need and the services. It will be going to be providing all the services, right? So virtualizations will come here, how they are going to be creating the virtual machines, right, according to the user, okay, according to the user's need and the demand, they are going to be providing the services, right? So load balancing also will comes in this cloud management layer, ma. So whenever one service provider is having some 30 to 40 virtual machines, okay, that are working under him, right? So you don't know, okay, so here whenever we are utilizing the services, okay, I have posted my website in cloud, ma. At that time suddenly my subscribers and the users has been increased, so definitely I need some virtual machine. Daily it will be consuming some 30 to 40 virtual machine, but suddenly due to World Cup, here subscribers and the users has been increased. Definitely here service providers, according to that, he have to increase the virtual machines. Okay, according to that, he have to provide the services, right? Every day you will be using some 30 virtual machine, but suddenly there will be an increase, right? In that case, they have to increase, okay? According to that, they have to decrease. Okay, this is not a simple job for the service provider. Depending upon their need and the requirement, they have to provide all the services to the users, okay, without affecting the SLAs, right? So these all things, they are going to be controlled and done by this all virtualization and load balancing. Mainly with the help of this load balancing, they are going to be controlling and providing the virtual machine based on their need and the requirements, right? And the last layer is hardware resource layer, right? So what is this hardware resource layer, ma? Mainly it will be providing, what it will be providing? All the hardwares, right? All the hardwares, resources it will be providing. So here, whatever the services we are utilizing from the cloud, from these layers, we are going to be utilizing the services, ma. And this layer is simply a collection of hardware resources, ma. They are going to be connected with some high configuration systems will be there. Okay, they are running some algorithms. With the help of that, they are going to be providing all the hardware resources to the users, right? So in this layer, definitely SLA will be affecting, okay? So at last two layers, SLAs are going to be affecting, right? And the first two layers, they are not going to be affecting anything, right? SLAs are not going to be affecting. Remember that words, okay? So clear any doubts till now? That is the architecture of overview. Next, we will continue with the another topic. Okay. So next, we are going to see the anatomy of the cloud. Okay, fine, ma. Thank you. So anatomy of the cloud. So mainly here we, what is cloud, how this cloud is working, difference from cloud and its architecture. First of all, we have to understand that, right? So cloud anatomy means it will be simply define the structure of the cloud, how it will be there, okay? What is the structure of the cloud, okay? It will be different from architecture. In architecture, what we are saying, ma? In architecture, we are how it's functioning, okay? Different layers, how they are providing the services, what are there? What are the things they are going to be providing to the users, that all thing. But in cloud, here, what is cloud anatomy? It will be just simply, it will be showing the structure of the cloud. Okay, cloud means like this. Okay, these all things will be available. Okay, it will be representing that all things, right? So here it may not include any dependency on which or over the technology works, right? So simply it will be showing the structure. It will be not depending on that, how it is working, what it is doing, this all thing. Okay, cloud meaning. So here we are having this cloud structure, ma. Like first it consists of applications, platforms, right? And virtualized infrastructures, virtualizations, server storage, data centers, right? So we'll see one by one, right? So here, first of all, cloud anatomy means it is a structure of the cloud. Here we are not going to be considering cloud architecture, right? Whereas in architecture, we are going to be defining and describing about like technology, right? How it is functioning, how it is working. These all things we are going to be defining, right? And this architecture is a hierarchical structural view, ma. Okay, hierarchical structural view means one by one, step by step, we are going to be viewing and we are going to be defining about its layers, how it will be working and how they are going to be dependent on each other, right? So like that, that is the architecture. So anatomy can be considered as a part of architecture. We can say it will be a part of architecture, right? So here we are having basic five components of the cloud, ma. So the first one is the application. Okay, application means the upper layer. So the upper layer is the application layer. Okay, in this layer mainly all applications are executed. Whenever the user are connected to the cloud, okay, they are going to be accessing with the web browser. Okay, they are accessing with the web browsers. Okay, they are connecting with the internet. At that time, they are going to be executing or opening any application. At that time, it will be, means it will be providing like that kind of a services, okay, to connect to the cloud. Okay, whatever the applications they are requested, that if they want to run or they want to execute or they want to view, okay, they want to create, these all things will be provided by this applications, right? So that is the first layer. And the second layer, platform layer, right? So these components here, and the second layer is platform layer, ma. So what this platform layer will be doing means, here this component consists of platforms, ma, that are responsible for the execution of the applications, right? Mainly this platform layer, it is located between application layer and virtualized infrastructure layer, ma. Okay, so mainly it will be providing a platforms for the developers, right? As we discussed in the services also, how platform as a service is providing the services, right? Whenever I'm not having any software to run my Java program or C program, at that time here they are going to be providing online compilers with the help of that, okay, without installation of anything, I can utilize that service, right? So here, platform, mainly it consists, okay, mainly it consists of a different platforms, okay, they are responsible for the execution of applications, okay, so whatever the applications I have requested from that, they are going to be providing one platform to the users, right, so and this layer is located between that application layer and the virtualized infrastructure layer, right, and next coming to the here infrastructure, ma, virtualized infrastructure, third layer. So what this infrastructure will be doing, ma, it will be providing all the resources, okay, all the resources over which other components are going to be working. Okay, simply we can say that virtualized infrastructure, it will be providing all computational capability to the users, right? Computational capability to the users or computing resources means blindly you have to remember that here four things are going to be provided. One is the CPU and the second one is the storage, right? Have you remembered that words? We all discussed four things, so it is going to be providing. And the third one is the RAM And the fourth one is the network bandwidth. Okay. Whenever I use the word computing resources or computational, okay, resources they are providing, means definitely these four things are going to be provided. So we have discussed this point in IaaS, infrastructure as a service also, right? So here virtualized infrastructure, here mainly it consists of different resources, okay? Different resources and the infrastructures, okay? According to that, they are going to be, according to the computational capability for the users, they are going to be providing all the infrastructure. That is the third layer, right? So coming to the virtualization, fourth layer, ma. Virtualization, already we have discussed the concept. What it will be happening here? Here, virtualization is the process of making logical components, right? Logical components of resources over the existing physical resources, right? Whatever the physical resources are there, with that we are going to be making it as a another, like with the help of that workstations, right? VMware, we have created and provided one logical environment, right? We are by providing our IP address, okay? We are providing some user details so that with the help of that, they are going to be utilizing the services, right? So here the logical components are isolated and independent, okay? Here they are going to be isolated and independent from which the infrastructure they have provided, right? So that is the virtualization. Mainly here, what we are doing means whatever the physical resources are available, okay? From that, we are going to be creating the logical, okay, logical components or the resources, that all things we are going to be providing to the service providers or the users, right? So they are independent and isolated. That will not affect to our system and will not happen anything to us, right? That is the fourth. That is the fourth, virtualization. Clear? And a last layer is physical hardware, okay? Physical hardware means they are going to be providing like a server, storage, data centers, right? So physical hardware is provided by the server and the storage units. So these all hardware things they are going to be providing, right? So this is about the cloud. This is about the cloud, ma. How the cloud structure looks means here main the application layer will be there. Platforms, okay, virtualized infrastructure and virtualization, and at last hardware layer. It consists of like a server and the storage data centers, right? So these are the basic components that are described in our cloud, right? Basic components, what are available, the main five components are available in this cloud, ma. So main components five. Clear? Anatomy of the cloud and five components. So the questions may be coming for three marks, or otherwise they will be giving A and B, okay? Cloud architecture one question and B they will be giving like this, right? So in this chapter we are having important topics. What topics are there, Ms.? One is the migrating, ma. One is definite questions from this topic means this. This is our syllabus, right? If you are having any doubts, you can ask.